regarding Leelavati and its connection with the later works like Kanaka Diyaram and Manakusar. So I will read out my paper. The twin branches of astronomy and mathematics occupy a prime position in the Indian sciences. The vast corpus of manuscripts in these twin branches have been extensively surveyed and documented in the last semi-century. About 90,000 source works of Indian astronomy and mathematics have been identified in the country. Though serious studies are taking place in this area, it should be clearly noted that only 5% of the source texts in manuscript form have been edited and published in late. The contribution of South India to these branches of sciences are well acquired now. In the bibliographic survey of Indian manuscript catalogs, this is the latest survey by S. C. Vishwas and M. K. Prajapati. So in this survey, the language-wise distribution of the catalog manuscripts are available. And from these, it can be seen that the major chunk of manuscripts are in Sanskrit and Prakrit, about 78.39%. And 8.26% manuscripts in Hindi. And 6.18 source works in South Indian languages, that is in Tamil, Malayalam, and Kannada, and the rest in other languages. So the works in South Indian languages grade top while comparing it with the manuscripts in other vernacular languages. This is one point to be noted. And scholars believe that the efforts in science, like mathematics, became stagnant with the Leelavati of Bhaskaracharya. So Leelavati comes in the 12th century. But later it was identified that at least in some pockets of South India, especially in Kerala, the glorious tradition of Indian mathematics was carried from the 14th century and it continued up to 18th century. Great strides were taken in the fields of trigonometry, real analysis, and in calculus. And the Kerala School of Mathematics became the center of attention for the scholars, as it anticipates many results obtained by the 17th and 18th century European mathematicians, which is highly commendable. Most of the texts during this period were composed in Sanskrit, as it was considered as the most suitable language for intellectual discourses. However, there are exceptions, as we have texts like Yukti Bhasha, in which all the Upabhaktis or rationales are extensively discussed in Malayalam. Very few texts are available having parallel presentation in Sanskrit and Malayalam. This Yukti Bhasha has a Sanskrit version. Except that this Malayalam version is composed initially, then it was translated into Sanskrit. So that Ganita Yukti Bhasha and Sanskrit is also available. Apart from these, historians like Ullu, Vadakkambu, Kunjuni Raja, they have documented information on vernacular mathematical works like Kanakku Shastra, Kanakku Chodyam, Kanakku Saal, Kanakka Dilara, etc. Each of these texts can be regarded as a genre of texts, as different kinds of texts are seen with the same title. There are several other mathematical treatises in Malayalam which await critical scholarly attention. Though some of these texts are published in modern editions, a more substantial engagement of these texts with the critical editions and explanatory notes have to be done. Here an attempt is made to raise the influence of Leelavati on the works of Kanakku Saaram and Kanakka Dilaram, published works Kanakku Saaram and Kanakka Dilaram. Kanakku Saaram published from Madras Government of Oriental Manuscript Library, and Kanakka Dilaram published from Kottayam. And thereby assess the transmission of knowledge. So the text Leelavati is regarded as the culminating point of a saga of mathematical activity in India. So after the Siddhanta period, so Leelavati is regarded as the crucial point in the history of mathematics. So the word Leelavati means Leelasya asti, so that which has play in it. As is well known, it is one of the major portions of a greater work called Siddhanta Shiromani of Bhaskaracharya. As the text itself claims, the brevity and clarity of the text attracted the author. Then the author himself claims that the Sankshipta Akshara Komala Alavadai. And in 266 verses, Leelavadi comprises the topics, the four simple rules, extraction of square root, cube root, rule of p, inverse problems, problems producing simple and quadratic equations, arithmetical and geometric progressions, permutations and combinations, volume of spheres and cones, etc. The number of commentaries testified to the popularity of Leelavadi. A.K. Bhatt has given a list of 40 Sanskrit commentaries of Leelavadi. Commentaries like Priyakramadi explain Leelavadi verses one by one and supplement the information contained in the Leelavadi with many new discoveries. Strictly speaking, many of the developments in mathematics are embedded in these commentaries of Leelavadi. No mathematical works in the country has got as much scholarly attention as Leelavadi has. Though the work being South Indian, said to be Bhattacharya, said to be given the place called Bijapur. Though there are disputes regarding where this Bijapur is born, most of the scholars claim that it is in Karnataka. So, though the work being South Indian, its popularity is spread throughout the country. But the background of problems dealt in Leelavadi closely resembles the North Indian culture. Similarly, the text Shruti Bhasha, in spite of being South Indian in its origin, the approach to the problems follows North Indian style. Texts having South Indian genus and Desi approach like Kanakadigaram have never been a main subject of discussion amongst the historians of mathematics. The critical edition of different Kanakadigaram need to be done initially. So, almost five different types of Kanakadigaram have been identified in Kerala. In texts like Kanakadigaram, an amalgamation of popularly known as the Maniprava style. Now both Sanskrit and Desi style can be seen. The author of Kanakasaran has explicitly stated that he is composing this work after closely reading Leelavadi and Kanakadigaram. Leelavadi nobi Kanakadigaram kante ennodu maliguru parannathum orthukonde bharatprabodhakaranaya maniprabhadai uttam mayatma hrudayena Kanakasaran. Hence, it is highly stimulating to investigate the assimilation of Leelavadi by this vernacular text and how these texts conceptualize the topics of Leelavadi. The genre of text, namely Kanakadigaram, is famous in Malayalam as well as in Tamil. Yesterday we have seen the discussion on Kanakadigaram Subbaiya. So, though the relation between these versions are not so clear, some scholarly articles on Kanakadigaram have appeared in the old issues of Bhavan's Journal. Studies by Kochipan Daragan in Malayalam Bhasha Roshni Journal. These are worthy to note. Then C.K. Musar, in his work Pradina Gadam Malayalam, have given information about one Kanakadigaram text. This may be a later combined one. So, author of this Kanakadigaram has been identified by Musar Das, Mavanan Mapkada Sahid Mohatasha. The language of the text is an amalgamation of Tamil and Malayalam. The verses are not in the form of Anushkar, unlike Sanskrit verses. Both the texts, Kanakadigaram and Kanakasaran, begin with the salutation of Lord Ganesha as in Leelavadi. Kanakadigaram thanne kavigal ketiyennuvan, thunakken karimukattom. So that word used in Leelavadi is Madangan.
ഏണാംഗശേഖരസുതം ഗണനാഥപ്രതിസൻ കണക്കധികാരം ഏണാംഗശേഖരസുതം ഗണനാഥമേറ്റം വന്ദിച്ചുവാണിയ വണങ്ങി ഹരിമുരുഞ്ച നാനാമുനിയും തൊഴുതുകൊണ്ട് കണക്കുസാരൻ നേരെ ചമപ്പതിന് സാമ്പ്രതമാരവേനാം കണക്കുസാരൻ. സോ ദ ഡേറ്റ് ഓഫ് ദ ടെക്സ്റ്റ് കണക്കധികാരം ഈസ് എവിഡൻസ് ഓഫ് ദ ടെക്സ്റ്റ് ആൻഡ് ഹാവ് ബീൻ പോയിന്റഡ് ബൈ മൂസർ. സകലവും കണ്ടതിൻ്റെ സാരമിങ് അറിവതിനായി വിവരമായുള്ളതെല്ലാം വിലകൂടും ഒഴിഞ്ഞതിനെ കൊല്ലം ഇങ്ങൊന്നിൽ നിന്ന് കൊള്ളും ഇന്നായിരത്തി മുപ്പതും എട്ടതോളം മുറയതായി ചെന്ന കാലം കൊല്ലവർഷം
മിസ്റ്റർ ഷെക്ടർ സാഹിബിന്റെ മേന്മയുള്ളതിനാലെ മാവനാൻ കണക്കറിനെ മറവിലാമേ മലയാളം റൈറ്റർ ഇ വി കൃഷ്ണപിള്ള is one of, in one of his writings has recorded many verses which he had learned in this from his school. Musadhar has identified some of these verses in Kanakadigara text and has given reference to this the verses. This is an ample evidence to prove that Kanakadigara was widely popular throughout the state and the verses therein have been memorized by even by the school children. There are different sections in the text as in Leelavati, like Pon Kanak, Nal Kanak, Paak Kanak, etc. Many translated verses from Leelavati can be seen in Kanakadigaram, whereas some verses are slightly modified. Of course, many independent verses can also be seen, which declares the identity of vernacular mathematics. Besides, the professional practice in mathematics and societal elements can also be well attested from the vernacular text. As for example, we can consider a verse from Panakusara. ഇരുന്നൂറ്റമ്പത് പണമിട കോഴിക്കോട് അർത്ഥമല്ലോ കോടക്കൽ 225 പണമിട കോളിന് പാലയൂർക്ക് The difference in units prevalent in Kozhikode, Kozhikode, Paliyur can be analyzed from the words. While describing the problems on gold, the methods for extraction of gold have been stated initially in Kanakadigara. പൊന്നതെടുത്ത് കൊണ്ട് കണക്കനും പണി ചെയ്യുന്നതിനായി പൊൻ ചുടുകന്ന് ചുടുകന്നും ഇത്തരമിട്ട് തീക്കനലും വിലക്കി പൊന്നതിലിട്ടുരുക്കി നിറം കലറും ഒരു കട്ടി തന്നെ കൽപ്പിതമായി വരുന്ന ഫലത്തെ നേരുക ചെയ്യുന്നതിനായി കൽപ്പടിയൊത്തു തൂക്കി ഉരച്ച് സൂക്ഷ്മമറിഞ്ഞും മാറ്റും മറ്റു കണക്കരും പലർ കൂടി കുറ്റുര ചെയ്ത് നന്നായി നൽപ്പണവും കൊടുത്തുള്ളറയകം പകരുന്ന നേരം നിറമറിയാതെ പൊൻകളവിന് മാറ്റുതിരിച്ചു ചൊല്ലുവാൻ നികരില്ലാതെ പൊന്നതിലുക്കം തെട്ടിയെയും വരുത്തി എക്സെട്ര ദീസ് കൈൻഡ് ഓഫ് ഡിസ്ക്രിപ്ഷൻസ് കാനോട്ട് ബി സീൻ in texts like Leelavati. Though the text Leelavati is highly poetical and cites example from practical life situation, it is evident that the societal or social practices are more reflected in the vernacular text. The author of Kanakasaram has clearly stated that different mathematical practices can be seen in different places. And even if it is not as per Shastra, efforts should be made to include these practices in the Shastra by the experts. ശാസ്ത്രോക്തമല്ലാതെയും മുട്ടു കാണാൻ ഗ്രാമങ്ങൾ തോറും നഗരങ്ങൾ തോറും എന്നാൽ അവർക്കെങ്കിൽ അതിനു ഭേദം കണ്ടിട്ടു ചേർത്തിയിടുക ശാസ്ത്രയിൽ. സോ ദി ഫ്ലെക്സിബിൾ അപ്രോച്ച് ടുവേർഡ്സ് ശാസ്ത്ര ഇസ് വൺ ഓഫ് ദി ക്യാരക്ടറിസ്റ്റിക്സ് ഓഫ് വെർണാക്യുലർ. In Leelavati, Supanakrita customary notation is list of various units of measurement, namely units of currency, measures of weighing gold, measures of length, volume and area, measures of volumes of grains, this can be seen. This is followed by the description of place value system of decimal numbers. Kanakasaram also begins with the same description. The only difference being the place value system of decimal numbers is described initially in Kanakasaram. This proves that the units of measurements necessarily have regional differences. However, some verses found in Kanakasaram are the exact replica of Leelavati verses. For example, can consider words. Cheru naadigal iva naalam prasthamal naalu kondathu aadhagamam naal aadhagamam dronam dronam 16 koodiya oru kaari. This Kanakasaram verse seems to be the mirror image of the Leelavati verse. ദ്രോണസ്തു ഖാര്യാ ഖലു ഷോഡശാംശ സ്യാദാഢകോ ദ്രോണചതുർത്ഥഭാഗ പ്രസ്ഥശ്ചതുർത്ഥാംശ ഇഹാഠകസ്യ പ്രസ്ഥാന്ദ്രിരാഗേ ഉടവ പ്രതിഷ്ഠ. ബോത്ത് ദ ടെക്സ്റ്റ് സേസ് ദാറ്റ് ദ്രോണ 1/16 ഓഫ് ഇറ്റ് ഖാര്യ ആൻഡ് ആൻ ആഠക 1/4 ഓഫ് ദ്രോണ ആൻഡ് പ്രസ്ഥ ഇസ് 1/4 ഓഫ് ആൻ ആഠക. ദ നോമൻക്ലേച്ചർ ഫോർ 1/4 ഓഫ് പ്രസ്ഥ is different in both texts. കുടവാലും ഇല്ലാത്തി ആൻഡ് ചെറുനാഴിയും നടന്നു സാർ. ഹൗ It can be inferred that both these units are one and the same. The word Kudava might have different equivalents in different languages. Also the phrase Akyayi in Lilavati should be noted, which means according to the ancients, Akyayi Kudava Pradishta. So ancients called it as Kudava. Similarly, consider the words Koshan, Karisham, Nari in the Balamuna in Kanastara, in the context of measures of being old. This is the exact translation of Lilavati portion, Karshayi Chaturbhishta, Karshayi Chaturbhishta, Palam Lilatna. Since both Lilavati and Kanakasaram are texts from South India, these similarities may not be just accidental. Standardization of units in South Indian political scenario should be taken into account, and close analysis of various units treated in Lilavati and texts like Kanakasaram should be done to get the notion of various units prevalent in the country, and to assess the shades of changes occurred in the concepts of units from time to time and from place to place. It goes without saying that concepts of units of measure have got a prime place in the conceptual history of mathematics. In the case of Indian tradition, where we get an integrated and holistic approach in all disciplines of knowledge, mathematics is seen not as an abstraction but as an applied science. When we come to the texts like Lilavati and Kanakasaram, it is evident that there is a background of practical life situation which posed the formation of a set of problems and their solution. The various social environments in which the authors of these texts interacted and in which they carried out their work need to be taken into account. Also, the conversion of units of measures might have been playing an important role in the development of science. By means of comparative studies of units in the Sanskrit texts like Lilavati and vernacular texts like Kanakasaram, we may be able to find answers to many important questions. Like, is the enumeration of units just another list, or has its contents been ever discussed and applied in later part of another text? What is the previous history of these units? Have the commentators as well as the followers and researchers on the text cared to analyze? It analyzes the conceptual history of these measures and units. What is the logic or rationale behind giving the list of units and measures at the outset of the text? So, place very much resemblance in stating the place value system of decimal numbers as well. As in Lilavati, we see Eka Dasha Shata Sahasra Ayuka Laksha Prayuka Kodaya Kramasha Arbuda Mabjam Karva Nikarva Maha മഹാകോടി ജലം പിന്നെ മഹാവെള്ളവും പരാഭ്രമിച്ചത്. Both the texts mention about 70 numbers starting from 1 up to 100 quadrillions, 10 to the power 70. The word parakram is common. But while reading Kanakasaram, we get the notion that the first 7 are one set. So they are Unnum Pattum, Padimurai, Ideyum, Uru Abayam, the Kanakasaram. Unlike in Lilavati, 70 numbers below 1, like Kadiranu, Timirima, Anu, Imi, these are described in vernacular texts like Kanakasaram and Kanakadigara. That description of fractions cannot be seen in Lilavati. In Kanakadigara, it can be seen, so this relation between Kadiranu, Timirima can be seen in Kanakadigara. Now we can come to the relation between the circumference and diameter of the circle. So, this ratio between the circumference and diameter of the circle was always been a subject of discussion for Indian mathematicians. We can find the discussion in Shubha Sutra, Jain works, Aryabhatiya, Lilavati, and extensively in later Kerala works. Sangamagrama Madhava has given the value correct to 11 decimal places. Yukti Deepika gives the value in terms of infinite series. So, Vyasen Varikini Kate. And Kerala Yogi Lakshmi Swami Aji in his Bhashya has given discuss the irrationality of pi have been discussed. So, however, the value seen in different Sanskrit and Pali sources differ slightly. For example, in Jain verse, being the earlier option, the value they are giving value as 3.09 or something. So, there are differences in the given values. In vernacular text also, the discussion can be seen. Gatushayus is the relation between circumference and diameter of the circle as Narmarajena Vattatthi Pijutti Saradangavum Kadicha Sukshmam Ayivittam Vattam Arichumam. So here the word Vattam indicates the circumference and Vittam stands for the diameter. And the word Kadikika means to divide. Now, Narmarajena in Kadabriyadi system denotes 1250 and in Saradangam when decoded will be 3927. Hence, as per the rules, to get the diameter of a circle, one need to multiply 1250 with the circumference and divide the result by 3927. So, the C by D will be 3927 by 1250 is 3.1416. So, this value, pi, this value implicitly stated in Kanaka Sarani is identical with the value given in Leelavati. Leelavati that Vyase Bhandakni Hare Bhakte Khabana Sudhe Paridhistu Sukshma. So that value is exactly the same. The same 3927 by 1250. C by D. And the later part of the verse in Leelavati. Dwarimsha Digne Vidradeyadha Sailai. Is formed in Kanakasara as Kadikya Vattatthine Vittamakam. So the most theme. As the author of Kanakasara has closely read Leelavati, these similarities may be accidental. The author of Kanakasara might be following first Karajarya consciously or unconsciously, but if this is a similarity amongst the text produced in Karnataka, Tamil Nadu and Kerala, then it will become a serious topic for discussion. Anyhow, while coming to the problem part, it can be seen that many of the problems discussed in vernacular texts are exactly the translation of Leelavati, meaning Leelavati verses. For example, we are considering a verse from Kanakasara, an interesting problem to be solved using Bhujabodhi Karmanyaya, known as Pythagoras theorem.
മരത്തിന്മേൽ.
സോ ദിസ് ഇസ് ദി എക്സാക്ട് ട്രാൻസ്ലേഷൻ ഓഫ് ദി ലീലാവതി വേഴ്സ്. വൃക്ഷാ ഹസ്തോച്ഛയാ സദൈവീ വാവീം കവിഃ കോപ്യതാ ഉത്തീര്യാഥ പരോഹൃതം ശ്രുതിപഥേന ഉദ്ദീയ കിഞ്ചിദ്രുമാ ജാതൈവം സമത അയോയതിഗതൗ ഉദ്ദീയമാനം ഉദ്ദീയമാനം ഉദ്ദീനമാനം യത് വിദ്വഞ്ജേ വിദ്വഞ്ജേ സുപരിശ്രമോസ്തി ഗണിതേ ക്ഷിപ്രം തഥാ രക്ഷമേ. സോ കോവി കവി സമംഗി ഉദ്ദി കമിന്ദം ഫ്രം വൃക്ഷ ആൻഡ് ഹസ്തശരോശ്രയ. So that is 100 cubits high and Vagi Maga, so in well, that is Shatayuge, 200 cubits away. Adha Paraha, another Mangi, Drudamuddiya, Kliyamina, Kinti Dhruma, Maga, that is this Mangi is coming, Shudivadhena, Shudivadhena, diagonally. Yadi Gadavuka Yoho, their distance Samadha is same, Hey Vidvan, Ganidesh Parishrama Asti, if you are work hard in mathematics, tell me you believe, mean Kshipra Mahadakshva, here Uddiyamanam or Uddiyamanam, what is the height of the jab. So, this kind of, this word is found in the exact translation, and Eerara kool neela midam padin kool, meelbhaga mamna adam reedu kool, Eerara kool neela midakki lanj, kolundadil kolkana mektrayinda. This is the translation of Kherasadvadaja Vastaduljan Vistaradhyam Kukaredadartham Yasyasabhi Saptakarashtaveda Kaat Sada Sankhya Vada Tatra Vapya. Similarly, the verse Padinaru Panattinam Kumpade Kaat Padam Sakhe Kungumam Kittanam Nadi
പണം അൻപതിനെത്രയാണ്? ഇസ് എ ട്രാൻസ്ലേഷൻ ഓഫ് കുങ്കുമസ്യ സതളം ഫലദ്വയം നിഷ്കസപ്തമലവൈസ്തൃഹൃതി പ്രാപ്യതി സപതി നിയമണിപ്പര ഭൂഹി നിഷ്ക നവകീന നൽകിയത്. ത്രൈരാശിക റൂൾ ഓഫ് ത്രീ പ്രോബ്ലംസ് ആർ ബോത്ത് കൈൻ ആർ സീൻ ഇൻ ബോത്ത് കൈൻഡ് ഓഫ് ടെക്സ്റ്റ് ആൻഡ് വൺ എക്സാമ്പിൾ ഗിവൻ ഇൻ ദിസ് കോണ്ടെക്സ്റ്റ് ഇൻ കണക്ക് സാരം ഈസ് അഞ്ചു വൈരം എട്ടു നീലം ആറു പുഷ്പം മുറുമുട്ട് അഞ്ചിയെ പകർന്നുറ മാണിക്യാഷ്ടകമിന്ദ്രനീലദശകം മുക്താഫലാനാം ശതം സദ്വജ്രാണി ച പഞ്ചരത്നമണികാമേഷാം ചതുർണാം ധനം സംഘസ്നേഹവശീനതേ നിജധനാത്വേകമേകം മിത്രോ ജാതാ തുല്യധനാ പ്രഭക്വദ സഖേ തത്രജ്ഞ മൂല്യാനി മേ. So these kind of similar problems can be seen. Just concluding, there is no doubt that the ornamental word Leelavati has been written influenced by the writings of Arikada, Varaha Mihira, Sridhara, Brahmagupta and others. But it is far beyond doubt that Leelavati was well received and assimilated by the later authors of Karnakara text, who may have followed different methods to solve the same mathematical problems in Leelavati. Though the Karnakara text deals with the daily life mathematical problem solving, unlike the higher levels of mathematics discussed in Leelavati, by clearly analyzing the influence of Leelavati in Karnakara text, we may be able to find the practical usage of higher mathematical works, regional understanding and conceptualization, and exchange of ideas and advancement in mathematical problem solving. So with this I conclude. Thank you.
Very interesting paper is now for a brief discussion. It contains a lot of information regarding the mathematical texts in Kerala. One point to be kept in mind is that these are the texts which were responsible for taking world mathematics forward in the advent of the missionary activities. Historians took these texts from Kerala to Europe and universities, and that was the beginning of a revolution in world mathematics that we should have to keep in mind before discussing all these things. There are several technical details mentioned in the paper. We unfortunately do have no time to go into deep of those technical details. We have just 5 minutes for our discussion.
Thank you very much. This is very, very interesting. I want to ask a question of sort of the philological remark. If you're looking at the Karakasara, then it says explicitly, I'm taking Karakatikara, I'm taking Leelavati and putting them together. And it's very clear that you find a translation from Karakasara and from Leelavati and Karakasara. But when you look at other versions of Karakatikara, I'm not sure how close they are to the Leelavati, and we should be very careful. Even if we find something very similar in Leelavati and Karakatikara, it doesn't mean it comes from Leelavati to Karakatikara, because the problems in the Leelavati, many of them are not original. Many of them can be found in other texts in India which are earlier, so they were just going around. And maybe it didn't come to the Karakatikara through the Leelavati, but something else. So we should be very careful trying to negotiate this relation and understand what were the relations between the higher science in mathematics represented by the Leelavati and the vernacular mathematics represented by the many, many different versions of Karakatikara.
It's precisely to avoid because there is an ease with which we say something came from Sanskrit to the vernacular. But we have not even started asking the question of, is there a possibility that something from the people's practices, workers' practices, got acquired different dimensions of language and recording in different registers. And I think it's important that we don't follow that ease and convenience. Just because some text came prior in time doesn't mean there is a logic of translation that automatically follows. And that's why we emphasize on the practice part as well as the socialistic part.
It is 1862, which means that by the time the British directly or indirectly have been ruling what is today modern Kerala for more than about 60-70 years. Already the modern schools have been established. Right? From 1818, modern schools have been established, and even the so-called Pinnipalipurams were getting under the influence of British, because there was a Grand Indian system, whereby the Pinnipalipuram, if they adhere to the British schooling, then they will get a grant from the government. Madras presidency had that scheme. I'm not sure about whether the Trivandrum followed it or not, but Madras presidency did follow that. So the question to ask is, 1862, when this text is produced, it's produced for whom? In which context they want to use this text? Right? I mean, it is clearly a text for teaching learning. It's a kind of a teaching learning material, right? So, is it produced for this new emerging clientele? That is why they picked up from two different areas, because now no longer the people who are coming to the school are the Karnam, are being trained to become Karnam. Or trying to become the Brahminical village appointed, or this. No, so there is, I mean, I think we need to also look into this kind of questions. Then the whole thing will become more interesting. So, which kind of problems are brought in from, even if it is brought in from Leelavati, which one? Which one from Kanakadigara, which seems to have a much earlier tradition, right? So, then we have a much more interesting question to ask. That's a comment.
It shows that in Mr. Shepster Sahib really requested to do this translation. Based on that request, only he attempted, made a, it is clear in the text itself. In terms of the question.